Alarming, confusing, illogical. The traffic light system. Not my words, that of a travel expert, indeed a travel chief executive. How proud are you to have presided over this shambles, Secretary of State?
No, I don't. Look, I don't agree. Another travel expert, one of the bosses at Gatwick, who said he thinks that the government advice is perfectly clear. Let me tell you exactly what I said when I launched the system Friday week ago, which is in a green list country, of which there are relatively few. You're able to travel. You don't have to quarantine when you get home. In amber and red, you must quarantine. Amber at home, in red, in a government-secure hotel. And you'll have to take pre-departure tests on all of them. And in amber and red, a day two and a day eight test. And in amber, you may even take a day five test for test to release. It is, you know, we are not encouraging people to travel in amber and red categories. And we're certainly not encouraging people to travel for holidays in amber. Either. So, you've got to have a system of some type, right? And every country in the world essentially is put into the middle, the amber category, until proved otherwise, either because they've got exceptional record on coronavirus and they get into the green category, or because there's a problem and they go into the red category.
5 million people have trips booked, mostly to mainland Europe. What would you tell them?
Well, right now, there aren't many locations. In fact, I can only really...
No, this is not the, of course, but Europe, in coming months. Yeah. What would you say to the Secretary of State?
I'd say, obviously, we're all going to have to be patient, because what's happened is the UK has ended up getting well ahead in terms of the number of Brits who've been vaccinated by comparison to elsewhere in Europe. But in a couple of months' time, I hope they will be catching up, and we'll have to see what happens. We'll go on the science and the evidence entirely.
But
we do want people to be able to travel, Nick. I'm not, you know, we are a global country.
Like
people,
Secretary of State.
People leave the country. Well, let's give you an example.
We have
actually
a knockout vaccination program, which is the envy of the world, courtesy of British scientists, the NHS, the British military, and the great blokes and women are out there doing it every day, many of whom are unpaid volunteers. So we have some... The European Union are likely to say, come one, come all to Britain's, but your government is going to say, yeah, sure, but you have to quarantine when you come home.
Yeah,
what was the purpose of the vaccinations?
Well, we'll be reviewing the list every 3 weeks. The next review is the beginning of June. So the who's on the green list will change. But
so we know there will be more. One can hope that the green list will grow and the amber list will shrink.
And one would hope the green, as those countries vaccinate and get on top of the situation, you'd hope that's the case. But I don't want to, you know, pretend otherwise. We are taking a very cautious approach. Why? Because the British people have spent much of the last year in lockdown, and we don't want people to have to go back there again. People come forward in record numbers for these vaccines, and we want to make sure that as we unlock, we're doing so absolutely safely. And I know there are people out there who say, oh, never mind, caution to the wind, let's just reopen this thing up. That's not where the British people are. People want to be cautious about this and get this right. And that is what we're doing.
Do you think...